American Top 40.
This next hit is by an English duo who say they arrived at their name this way. Their sound combines a European synthesizer with rhythm. That's why David Stewart and Annie Lennox call themselves the Eurythmics. Their first American hit climbed 5 notches this week to number 32. Here's Sweet Dreams.
Sweet dreams are made of
ice. Moving from 37 to 32 in our countdown of the 40 biggest hits in the USA, the first chart single by the Eurythmics, a duo out of London, Annie Lennox and Dave Stewart. Sweet dreams are made of this, and the countdown rolls on. Well, now we're up to our new number one song by a duo who claim ghosts are helping them tidy up their recording studio. This is the story told us by Englishman Dave Stewart and Scotswoman Annie Lennox, who together form the act called Eurythmics. Recently, Dave and Annie put all their money into an old abandoned church in London. They took out a 21-year lease and set about converting it into a studio and rehearsal hall. And there's been a lot of work to do. It's a very old building. Part of it is in ruins and rubble. But that doesn't bother Annie and Dave. They're also not bothered by the fact that the church seems to be haunted. Dave says, quote, "Apparently it used to belong to an 18th century religious group called the Agapemonites, who were a sort of free love cult, persecuted and hounded out of existence." End of quote. Dave claims that a ghost or something has been moving and clearing away bits of rubble in the church. He says after we've finished for the night, they go to work, because when we arrive the next morning, a good 2 hours of work has been done for us, so I believe them to be friendly. End of quote. I wonder if that ghost does windows. But Dave Stewart and Annie Lennox couldn't care less. Their song has just hit the top. The new number one song in the USA is Sweet Dreams by Eurythmics. And there it is, the new number one song in the USA. After 4 consecutive weeks at number 2, Eurythmics move into the top position with Sweet Dreams Are Made of This.
American Top 40.
This is Casey on American Top 40 in Hollywood. Now we're up to the odd couple of the charts, a male and female duo. To borrow examples from the hit TV series, he's like Oscar Madison, a real slob, while she's like Felix Unger, too fastidious. I'm talking about Englishman Dave Stewart and the lady from Scotland, Annie Lennox, the duo who comprise Eurythmics. Annie Lennox says we're complete opposites. Dave's a total optimist, well-balanced and undaunted by anything, whereas I'm a depressive pessimist. And Dave Stewart says, quote, "We work completely different, too. I work amazingly quick, whereas Annie is more selective. She'll spend 2 weeks on just 4 lines of lyrics, while I tend to have 12 backing tracks and bits of melodies all over the place. But that's our different personalities." Dave goes on to say, "My apartment's like that. Stuff all over the floor and tapes hanging out of cupboards. But Annie's place is very neat and precise. But that works well. If we were both like me, we'd probably have about 1,000 unfinished songs, and if we were both like Annie, we'd probably have just 1 single every 2 years. Annie and I love that sort of duality." End of quote. Here's the act who make their differences work for them, not against them. Dave Stewart and Annie Lennox at number 18 with their 6th top 40 hit in the USA, Would I Lie to You? Eurythmics on American Top 40 after 4 consecutive weeks in the top 10, where they reached number 5. Last week they fell to 10. This week they're at number 18. A recent number 1 song in Australia called Would I Lie to You? Eurythmics as the countdown continues.
The hits from coast to coast.
I'm Casey Kasem. This is American Top 40. How do you get started in the music business? Well, here's how Dave Stewart of Eurythmics says it happened for him. Quote, "When I was 12, I broke my knee in a soccer match and was in the hospital for ages. I got so fidgety that someone brought me a guitar. I drove the nurses mad picking at it all day. And as soon as I got home, I stole my brother's Mississippi John Hurt albums and taught myself blues guitar." End of quote. And that was the beginning of Dave Stewart's guitar playing career, which led to Eurythmics. Here's Dave with his co-Eurythmic Annie Lennox at number 26 with a number 1 song out of England. There Must Be an Angel. Eurythmics at number 26, moving up a notch, fourth week in the countdown with There Must Be an Angel.
Casey's Coast to Coast.
Here's a mixed duo from the British Isles. He's English, she's Scottish, and together they've made some of the most riveting records and fascinating videos of the decade. They're Dave Stewart and Annie Lennox, Eurythmics. And Dave told us that he and Annie form a core, and they try to work with different musicians, video directors, and so on.
You can wear yourself out very easily if you become successful. So Annie and I tend to play with fresh people all the time and limit our amount of activities in one area. So we'll do recording, and then we'll do some film music, and then we'll make a video, and then we'll do some animation, then we'll do some live gigs, and everything is much fresher, you know?
The versatile Eurythmics are at number 13 on the 40 top newcomers of the 80s. Would I Lie to You? That's Eurythmics, Dave Stewart and Annie Lennox. They come in at number 13 as we count down the most popular newcomers of the 80s.
The hits from coast to coast.